Robbie, why is my dog still limping? This video 2 in a 6 video series that discusses conditions that cause limping in dogs. In this video, I'm going to discuss canine patellar luxation. So what is canine patellar luxation? Patellar luxation is just a slippage of the patella or kneecap. That's my kneecap right there. Right? So it means normal position at the front end of the knee. Why and how does this slippage happen? Let's go ahead and find it in this video. What is the patella or what is the kneecap? The patella is a tiny bone enclosed in the tendon. The tendon is also named patellar tendon. The medical term for a bone encapsulated in the tendon is sesamoid bone. Let's look at the patellar tendon now, right? Patellar bone and patellar tendon on these two very beautiful images here. Alright. This is the lower end of the femur, right? And this is the quadriceps tendon, alright? Or quadriceps femoris tendon, right? This is the patella here. And the patella is enclosed in the patella tendon or patella ligament, whichever way you want to call it. Alright? So, the patellar tendon is attached to the tibial tuberosity right here. Tibial tuberosity, right? That's the tibial bone. That's the femur. These are the other structures of the knee, right? You got a articular cartilage. You got lateral caudal, you got anterior cruciate ligament, you got posterior cruciate ligament, you got a collateral ligament here, right? A left collateral ligament right there, you have the medial collateral ligament, you have the meniscus lying here which cushion the femur and the tibia. Alright, we are interested in the patellar ligament, right? So this is the patellar bone, and this is the bed of the patella, which is called the trochlear groove, right? The patella lies here and it glides along this groove here to help with the movement of the stable joint, or the knee joint, right? That's the tibia, that's the femur, that's the patella. That's the trochlear groove on which the patella resides, right? Because it's very deep there. So that in a normal dog, the patella should not be able to scrape out of this groove, right? The patella should be able to be confined within this groove and the patella ligament or patella tendon, right? Here the anterior and posterior cruciate ligament, posterior cruciate ligament, right? So the patella in a normal healthy knee joint should not be able to get out of the trochlear groove, but it does. That's the topic of this video. The patellar tendon is considered to have an extension of the quadriceps tendon. The quadriceps femoris is a group of 4 muscles that originate from the hip bones, and the proximal or upper end of the femur. These 4 muscles cover the front part of the femur, form the quadriceps tendon distally, and attaches the patellar tendon. The patellar tendon attaches to the tibial tuberosity, which is just a prominent bump on the front end of the proximal tibial bone. As you can see here, right? Tibial tuberosity. Patellar tendon, patellar ligament, get attached there. Alright, the quadriceps muscle flex the hip and extend the stifle and the knee joint. The trochlear groove is a depression on the front and the lower or distal head of the femur that hold and keep the patella in place. The patella and the sternum enable the knee joint to function smoothly while extending or flexing the leg. Why does the patella slip out of the trochlear groove if the groove is such a comfortable bed? Patellar luxation is believed to be a congenital developmental misalignment of the whole leg from the hips to the toes. Right. Here are three very beautiful images. Of a normal patellar tendon, the two abnormal displacements, right? That's the femur. This is the patellar bone here, the patellar tendon, the patellar ligament, whichever way you want to call it. That's the tibia. You can see the patella in this diagram is right. It is very sitting, it is sleeping very comfortably in the trochlear groove. In this one, you can see that the patellar tendon has woken up and escaped from the trochlear groove, right? There's a movement to the medial side, right? Luxating, medial luxating patella. On this one, the patella is awake again and it has moved to the lateral side, okay? Maybe the sleep is not very good, it has woken up and got on this side, on the left side, on the lateral side, right? So, most of the luxations are to the medial side, right? Most of the luxations of the patella is to the medial side, as you note, you run why right now. The patella could luxate due to abnormal conformation of the hip joint, malformation of the femur or the tibia, atrophy or muscle loss of the quadriceps muscles or loose patellar tendon or ligament. Due to the genetic nature of patellar luxation, it's recommended that dogs diagnosed with patellar luxation should not be bred. If you draw a straight line, just an end here, let me put this image on there. If you draw a straight line from the hip joint to the central part of the same leg in a dog with normal leg conformation, the line will pass through the patella and the calcaneus bone of the hip joint. This is the leg conformation of a normal dog, right? If you draw a line from the hip joint, it should pass through the knees, pass through the hip joint, the calcaneus bone, and straight into the central part, right there. See on the both sides. If a dog has a lateral deviation of the stifle joint, right? When you draw the same line, the stifle joint will move out of the line. Right? It's just going this way, right? And the hip joint will move inwards. In that case, if you have a lateral deviation of the hip joint, you have and you draw the same line, both the stifle joint and the hip joint will be completely out of the line. Yeah, it will be lateral to the line. Okay. In both these lateral, in those both the medial or lateral deviations of the stifle joint and the hip joint, these dogs are likely to have problems with patellar luxation. That's how the leg conformation should be. So most dogs will have different deviations. They may be mild, they might be severe, but any deviation from the right side there is likely that dog is going to be prone to patellar luxations. All right. So if you draw the same line in a dog with a lateral knee deviation, the knee joint will shift to the lateral side of the line, or the hip joint will shift to the medial side of the same line. If you draw the same line in a dog with a lateral hip joint deviation, the knee and the hip joints will shift to the lateral side of the line. both dogs with lateral knee and hock joint deviation are very likely to develop medial patellar luxation. Patellar luxation is common in small breed dogs like Boston and Yorkshire Terriers, Chihuahuas, Pomeranians, and Miniature Poodles. Medial patellar luxation is more common than lateral luxation because medial knee and hock joint deviations are pretty rare. What are the clinical signs of patellar luxation? I normally refer patellar luxation as the nuisance medical conditions. Why do I do that? Because a slipped patella is not painful. It just annoys the little dog that cannot use the affected leg at will. A slipped patella makes the affected leg shorter, and the dog has to either extend or check the leg to allow it to slip back into the groove or just walk on three legs. How do you diagnose patellar luxation? Clinical signs, palpation and radiographs will lead you to the right diagnosis. Patellar luxation conditions are graded into four classes, with number one being the mildest, where the patella temporarily slips, then returns back on its own. In number four, patellar luxation, the patella is permanently luxated and it needs manual intervention to push it back into the groove. How do you treat patellar luxation? In grade 3 and 4 patellar luxation, surgery to realign the leg conformation of the affected leg is the standard treatment. For grade 1 and 2 luxation, I usually advise the client to avoid rigorous physical activities that hasten frequent patellar luxations. Your veterinarian will determine the right treatment for your dog. That's the end of the video. If you liked what you had, you can subscribe, share it, comment, or ask a question below. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.